Hello, I'm Kari Horowicz, the librarian for the College of Art and Design. Welcome. This is the second session in the Level Up Virtual series. Level Up Virtual is a series of short presentations aimed at highlighting various library resources, tools, potential uses, and expertise that can potentially help. We are currently in virtual mode, and you can find recordings and resources on the info guide at infoguides.rit.edu/LUV. Okay, now I'm going to share my screen to present to you all. Where is your library? So we're going to discover Wallace on Ice, our new temporary location, but we have a couple different places that we're living, the whole RIT Libraries, and I want to talk about that briefly. So the RIT Libraries is in a variety of locations now for approximately 2 years due to the construction of the Student Hall for Exploration and Development called the Shed. So we have essentially four locations or four collections in three locations. There's the Wallace on Ice in Ritter Arena. There's our offsite collections. And then we have the RIT Archives and Kari Graphic Arts collections, which are relocated in the Wallace Library on the west end of the second floor. And I'm going to show you just a brief few visuals so you get a sense of what's going on. So Wallace on Ice is really what the focus of this presentation is going to be on, but it is in the Ritter Arena, and I'm going to be showing you how to get there and what services are available and collections are available there. The other area is the offsite collections, and it is not available for browsing, but it's very, very accessible, and I'll talk about that briefly in a little bit. And then the RIT Archives and the Kari Graphic Arts Collection are still here in the Wallace Library building that you are commonly familiar with. They are, however, not available for walk-in appointments or walk-in visits. The front doors within the lobby of the library are in fact locked, but you can certainly visit. The image on the right is a photograph that I took of the classroom just this morning. So they want to welcome you, and their email is on the screen, RIT Archive at RIT for RIT Archive materials, and the Kari Graphic Arts Collection is kari@rit.edu. So what's in Wallace on Ice or the Ritter Arena? We have our circulating book collection and also our journals and magazines. We have a fully staffed circulation desk where we can loan laptops. You can get your course reserves that are printed, physical books that your professors may have put on reserve for you to read. We also have a large collection of DVDs. We also have, this is where you can pick up your books if you put requests on them, and I'm going to talk about that in a little bit. And this is also where you can pick up your interlibrary loan requests. Also in Wallace on Ice, we have an instruction space, and we call it the Instruction Junction, and it's a series, three rows of tables where classes come in and use the collection and learn about the resources that we have. We also have two print and scan stations, a microfilm reader printer for you, public computers to use, seating and study areas. Wi-Fi and wireless printing is available throughout the building and Wallace on Ice or the Ritter Arena. So how do you get to the Wallace on Ice? So this map shows you the location of the Wallace Library as many people commonly know it. It's right across the way from Liberal Arts. And you can see on this map that the shed construction zone is in between the library and Monroe Hall or the Student Alumni Union or SAU. So there's a green path that takes you to the east towards the dorm side, and you walk to the Albert Paley Sentinel big sculpture and you take a left. We also have a blue path for a wheelchair accessible entrance, and it's on the ground level and it's easy to get to. You just have to go to, down a ramp across the bridge. I'm just showing you my scenic route. I have the Kari scenic route, and I am in the RIT Libraries or the Wallace Library building, and I often go by the Tojo Memorial Garden. It's a beautiful spot right now in the fall, and it goes by the Gannett building, and then there's a path that goes by the Bausch and Lomb building that takes you down. I'm going to just show you a few photographs just to get a sense. There's the Albert Paley Sentinel, and there's a sign that says now open Wallace Library and Ritter Arena. And then there's the entrance, a student walking into the Frank Ritter Ice Arena. There's a sign to indicate that the library is downstairs. If you're using the accessible entrance, you will just come in on the ground level and you don't have to worry about stairs. So here's the entrance again to the Wallace on Ice Ritter Arena, showing the entrance way and showing our sign about advancing knowledge, sparking creativity, and connecting communities, our mission. So the Wallace on Ice Ritter Arena, this is the ice level, and this kind of outlines where the collections are. We use Library of Congress, and they're arranged alphabetically A to Z several times throughout the building. The green indicates sort of the regular section, and then oversized in the light blue and huge and so forth. You'll see that there are tables on the bottom part of the image in the study zone area. These are tables for you to study. And then the upper part of the image, there are tables as well, but those have computers on them. So you can have computer access. You can sign onto one of the computers there. And the round little circles that are underneath those are high top tables where you can stand or sit at high chairs and work. And then at the far end, you see the instruction junction, the three rows, that's our classroom. And then on the big area, the light gray is our circulation department and our interlibrary loan. And lots of folks working back there to make things accessible for you. And there's also a printer and scanner on the far southern end. And then there's also, just this is missing on this map, but there's another one here next to the circulation area. So then on the upper level, there's a lot of stands, so you can certainly sit in the stands if you like. I did that today, but there are tables and study areas, and there are study pods, the Brody chair study pods. Those are the little sort of pill-shaped lozenges that you see in this map. There's a fair amount of study space, but clearly not as much as we had in our original building here, the main library building. So we want to let you know that there are additional study spaces outside of Wallace on Ice that we've identified here. These are sort of neutral zones, so to speak. You can also connect with your fellow classmates in your own college to find study areas that may be unique to your college. But these are the general ones that we think are very good for people to find additional study spaces. So now I want to talk a little bit about the circulating collections. There's obviously in the Ritter Ice Arena, you know, about 140,000 titles in the Wallace on Ice or the Ritter Arena. And there's a little over 200,000 in our offsite collections. And so I want to make sure that you understand that you can access both very, very easily by using the request button. And the next slide kind of explains that not only do you have access to the Wallace on Ice and the RIT offsite collections, but you can access even more titles using a resource that we have called Connect New York, a partnership that we have with other institutions in New York State where we can borrow resources. And then IDS Express is our interlibrary loan system that allows us to borrow things from the world. So this lovely sort of sunshine arc depicts kind of the types of things and the access you have to Wallace on Ice and beyond. So I want to talk about the request button. It's a really great feature. You can request anything using this button in the library catalog. You can request books that are even in Ritter, and we will pull them for you and have you them available for you at the circulation desk, or they can be requested from off-site storage using this button in the library catalog. So I'm going to walk you through that step really quickly. So the request button in the library catalog is featured right here. There's a green arrow that is looking for this book on Willa Cather, The Emerging Voice, and it is indeed off in the offsite area, but you can request it, and it's an easy button to click on, and then you put your RIT username and password in and click submit, and then your request will come in approximately 24 hours. We have a full-time staff person working in the offsite collection and comes and delivers twice to the Wallace on Ice and the Ritter Arena, sometimes more if needed. So we've also have an enhanced book cover browse function in our library catalog. And I've just given you an example here of a title dealing with industrial design, Open Design Now. And if you scroll down a little bit on that entry, you can see the browse shelf on the right-hand side. It says browse shelf, and you can see the full shelf if you'd like to. And when you click on that full shelf, you can actually see it's fully responsive design. This is actually an image that you could have on your phone. So you could be browsing the covers of the books while you're in the stacks as well. So this is a really enhanced and wonderful feature that we've added to the library catalog. So we want to make sure that you know that assistance and research help is available all the time via our chat, via email, via Zoom, in various timeframes, not all the time, but through various timeframes. And the modalities for consultations could be in person or Zoom will vary among the librarians. So please note the info guide that's on the bottom of the page, infoguides.rit.edu/construction, because this links to all the ways that you can contact us for assistance and research help. And all the librarians are listed on this page as well. So feel free and take advantage of our assistance and research help that we can give to you. We are here for you. This is your library, so please ask questions and give us suggestions. Thanks for attending today, and please email us with any questions at libraryhelp@rit.edu.